The national carrier can now handle all aspects of passenger travel, from check-in, security, baggage handling, grooming of the aircraft or cleaning, as well as carrying out ramp handling services and safety requirements. It originally outsourced the services from DAS, a private company, but starting November 1st, 2022, the company recruited 200 employees who now handle most of the services. The Uganda Airlines Head of Corporate Affairs and Public Relations Officer, Shakila Rahim Lamar, said that the self-handling project was one of the measures intended to cut down on the operational costs and counter losses that the airline was currently faced with.
Self-handling saves money in a way that, because all the flights start from Entebbe, our hub, we're able to handle all the flights going out to the 11 destinations. So we find that the grooming of the aircraft, the handling of passengers, it all starts here. Because we have transiting passengers also from Bujumbura, from Juba, from Kinshasa, going to Dubai and returning to their countries of origin. So we find that, I think, self-handling, it's a very good, the right direction.
She explained that, according to their business plan, self-handling was supposed to start 5 years after inception, but it was brought forward after picking lessons from the COVID-19 upsets and embarked on preparations to start managing most of the activities by themselves to cut down on spending.
To develop our cargo operations. That is why we are getting two freighters, one long haul and one mid-range, to be able to carry cargo regionally and also globally. Because we think now the next goal in cargo, remember when COVID hit, people were just on their laptops ordering things that they were coming in. So many airlines converted their aircraft into cargo, for example, the Kenyan example, PQ and others, and ET. So that is where we want to go as an airline, to invest in cargo operations so that we can able to manage make us break even in the long run.
The Parliamentary Committee on Commissions, State Authorities and State Enterprises COSASE revealed that the company made a loss of 49.8 billion shillings in 2 years. Lamar acknowledged the losses the airline had incurred, as she explains.
We are still making those losses. Why? Every time you open a route, what does that mean? Because you have to market it. You have to have ground standards, you have to pay overflying, you have to pay all these other regulatory requirement fees.
She says the company is currently enabling local engineers to advance in skills so that they can maintain the aircrafts themselves. Engineer Derek Ouma, the head of the deputy managers, said the company had procured a number of equipment under the self-handling project, which are used for maintenance of aircrafts. However, he says the equipment are kept away due to limited space.
Just other equipment, buses, they call them ramp buses, and a few other high loaders. But then if they even came in right now, we totally have nowhere to put them.